7:45, it is one of the biggest evenings in the award season. 2013 Grammy Awards going to kick off tonight.
Yes, it is big, and here to talk about this year's Song of the Year Grammy nominees and predictions, former Grammy nominee and artist Lord Craven. He is here hanging out with us. You look fabulous.
Thank you very much.
You are continuing the KTLA tradition of dressing like it's not 46 degrees outside.
Yeah. See, and even if it is 46 degrees, I'm still dressing like
that. Yeah, but you've got some fabulous leather pants on, so you're warm.
Thank you. Yeah, I do.
Yeah, keeping you warm. So tell us, you were nominated several years ago for what?
And I did a duet with, well, not really a duet, a feature on this artist, this hip-hop artist called Name It, Etc. For Clear. So
how exciting was that?
Oh, it was great. It was really
great. So to be nominated, all these folks out there, you know, they're looking to make a lot of money, but to be nominated is a big deal.
Absolutely. You know, it's kind of gives you a little bit of validity and to an artist who has always worked really hard, it's like, you know, they feel like they're accomplishing something, you know, they feel like they've arrived, you know, so it's great.
Some of the ones that are going to be arriving tonight, talking about the Song of the Year artists, the ones that are nominated, here's one, Ed Sheeran and the A-Team. What do you think about this?
I think that's a great ballad. You know, I think Ed Sheeran is a great artist. You know, he's really known for more music, for more dance music, but his ballad took off, you know, it's great. It's
like this and Mumford and Sons and all that, it doesn't sound like a Rihanna kind of year. It sounds more like this, I don't know what this is, like rock of some sort or something.
Yeah, I think people just want something different. Yeah. You know what I mean? You know,
a little diversity.
Yeah, I think it's we're more than just dance. You know what I mean? So I'm really excited that Ed, has really, did really well with this ballad, you know. So
and then we've also got Miguel up for Adorn.
Yeah, that's a great song too. Yeah. I like that song too. You know, Miguel is a great guy. I haven't had the opportunity of meeting him, but we've been kind of close to each other. But it's a really great song. So
is this his first nomination?
I think so. I think this is a song that really just, you know, catapulted him.
This one rated number one song of 2012. Carly Rae Jepsen, Call Me Maybe.
I know it's not the most creative song, but come on.
Maybe.
That song is infectious. It's contagious. You know, it was just a pop culture phenomenon. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I mean,
and a cool video.
Absolutely. And you know, I mean, it's so many parody videos all over the web. Yeah. You know, it's been overplayed on the radio.
Think she can win though?
She's taking it home.
Oh, you think so?
Yes.
Even though it's not artistically the most creative, it's not the song.
It's just a feel-good song. And she's such a sweetheart too. I met her on Friday and
beautiful.
Yes, she is. So I think she definitely.
I don't know. Kelly Clarkson with Stronger. I feel like that's a strong. Yeah. You know, I guess.
Kelly Clarkson,
entry as well.
Yeah, Kelly Clarkson could do no wrong for me personally. Yeah. I just as a vocalist myself, she is a phenomenal vocalist. Mm-hmm. And I have actually met her too, and she's a sweetheart as well. But I'm not sure if that song is strong enough to actually take home that coveted
trophy. The other one that got just about as much airplay on the radio and downloads and otherwise is, you know, We Are Young, right? That was like the other anthem song of the year.
Fun is just fun. You know, that's a great song. And I think that's a strong contender as well. Yeah. So I think my projection, I think that Carly Rae Jepsen is going to take it. If she doesn't take it, I think it's going to go to Fun.
Well, we'll have to check it out. It is tonight. Right. But you have your own single, Lord Craven.
Yeah.
And it's just Breathe.
Yes.
Or Breathe.
Breathe. Everybody need a moment to just breathe.
Yes, we do. You know? So let's take a listen.
I like it. You're not so much on the auto-tune. It's like real legit.
Thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, that's very cool.
So, do you sing?
Oh, you know, not at all.
But you know, but you know auto-tune when you hear auto-tune.
Yeah, my ears work. My mouth, not so much.
I don't even know that thing, but it's a good thing that we don't sing on.
You're going to be on the red carpet.
I'm going to be there. I'm going to show up and hopefully show out in some of my.
What are you wearing?
I'm wearing Lord Craven. By Lord Craven.
Oh, of course.
So it's going to be, you know, a little avant-garde.
You know that the CBS big boys and girls put out the big memo. You're not supposed to show any stuff.
Yeah. I think arms is an exception. I think that's okay. I'm not showing any other body parts, but just a little arms.
Here's your website if you want some information about Lord Craven and want to interact with him. Here's all the stuff, the website, the Twitter, and all the rest. And, of course, you can purchase Breathe, a great song there on iTunes, Amazon, all the rest of there as well. well. Thanks so much for being here this morning. Look forward to seeing you tonight.
It was an honor. Thank you so much.
It was nice to meet you. Great tattoo on your arm, too.
Thank you.
Okay, good luck with everything.
7:50 right now. The time coming up. Gig Sagley from Travel Zoo here with a great deal to Calistoga, plus an airline that is starting child-free seating areas.